Oftentimes, mamas talk to me about being in an anterior tilt or a sway back position. One thing I want to emphasize is that these aren't necessarily a diagnosis and not inherently bad. It becomes difficult when we get stuck in these positions and we're not able to have variety in our movements. So both of these presentations need hamstrings. Hamstrings, specifically the proximal hamstrings, help control the position of the pelvis in the sagittal plane. We want to be able to control our pelvis front to back so that we can then control our pelvis side to side. The hamstrings are involved in all of it, but that's kind of where we start. When we think about an anterior tilt and someone who is living in more of that forward dumped position and that rib flare, the hamstrings are going to help bring us back into more of a neutral. So we can begin coaching more of a posterior tilt, because if we can posteriorly tilt versus just being in that anterior tilt, then maybe we can find a middle ground and find that more stacked position at the pelvis while we're also addressing what's going on at the rib cage. If we are in more of a sway back posture, we still need hamstrings to help us orient the pelvis, but we maybe just need to go about it in a little bit different way. So we want to learn how to sense our hamstrings, but without clenching the glutes and shoving forward at the same time. So if we're setting up in something like a 90-90, which is a drill I often do, a great little tool to be able to do is to use a towel roll and kind of place it above the sacrum so the pelvis kind of tips forward just a tiny bit so you can kind of restore a little bit of that lumbar curve. And we'll perform our 90-90 in that position so you can sense and feel your hamstrings without clenching on the glutes the entire time. If you're someone who's in more of an anterior tilt presentation, then we might use the towel to essentially bring the ground closer to you. So if you are in more of that anterior tilt, here's just a quick demonstration, and your pelvis is really not dumped forward, if I tell you to bridge up, then the whole pelvis and this body tends to move as a unit versus us actually getting that sense of the ground and that posterior tilt and then kind of bridging up. So sometimes placing a towel roll to just bring the ground closer to you can be really helpful. And if you're in that sway back presentation, like I mentioned, we still need hamstrings, but we want to think about even just restoring a little bit of that curve slightly so we can kind of allow the pelvis to kind of come forward a little bit. You don't want the towel roll too thick. And just breathing in this position to allow the muscles, the posterior pelvic floor, to kind of relax and lengthen all these muscles on the back of the glute. So just let go. And we can feel the hamstrings by dragging the feet down the wall, but our glutes are not in a clenched position. We're allowing them to kind of open up. The other thing with a sway back position is we want to be able to lengthen the glutes. And in order to eccentrically lengthen, so thinking like something like a rock back where we actually allow these muscles to lengthen behind us, we need to be able to open up what's going on back here. So posterior pelvic floor release and breathing exercises, getting some manual work there, utilizing some of those yoga tune-up balls or a foam roller to just kind of get back there as well. And a pelvic floor PT can be really helpful. So both groups, an anterior tilt and a posterior tilt, need hamstrings. We might just go about it in a little bit different of a way, because with the posterior tilt, if you're already in that sway back, we don't want to encourage you to tuck, tuck, tuck even more, because ultimately we're squeezing the glutes, thrusting forward, and that's taking us into a position we don't want to go, because we want to lengthen. Any questions on how to work in a, or what exercises you should do, or how we can approach in both positions? Let me know.